By the time we find our way to Mohammed's meat stall, he and his team are turning this morning's camel into this afternoon's lunch. The organs go into the saute pan.
He has liver.
Liver and
the testicles.
The testicles.
The fat from the camel hump, along with some muscle and sheep fat, goes into the meat grinder with some extra ingredients to make camel kebabs. But here's how it works in the souk. One stall sells the raw meat, another one makes and grills the kebabs.
We took the ground camel meat down here, a couple of kilos worth, brought it to this guy who shaped it onto kebabs, and he's grilling it right now over the coals, and then he'll hand it back to us and we'll truck it on back down and feed all the butchers. Thank you very much. Thank you, it's beautiful. That's some grilled camel. Oh, beautiful. He's on the phone with his stockbroker.
Actually, it's the wife checking up on him. It's a cultural universal.
Oh, very nice. Ground meat, liver, the balls. Fantastic. A little camel sausage. Wow. You would never know that you weren't eating beef. Solid, beautiful, bovine goodness, despite the fact that this isn't cow. The camel tastes very, very sweet.
This is called source thrumming, sour herring. Left to rot for a full year before it's ready to eat, the gaseous buildup inside has already bent the metal can. What began as necessity for preserving food has become a national source of pride, in part because it's so ghastly.
Look at you turning your head!
The can literally spews its contents when opened. And the most penetrating, putrid, powerful stink I've ever smelled from food rolls across the rooftops.
Wow! Holy moly, so this just goes in there raw. Oh my gosh, guts included. Fantastic.
By the time I'm ready for the first bite, the entire embassy staff is lined up to watch.
That's what happens on this show. Nobody's interested until the fermented fish comes out of the tin. And then everybody wants in. All right.
He smelled it. Oh.
This is one of the rankest things I've ever smelled.
Mm-hmm.
This
I'm also is just horrific. Wasn't that? Nice, isn't it?
It's not nice.
No?
But it will be nice.
That's
when
year-old rotted fish. I mean, it just says it all. That's it. That's the most rotten piece of seafood I've ever eaten, and that's saying a lot. That's like licking the inside of an ammonia container.
Turns out, few people today eat this stuff by itself. Now they tell me. They usually mix it with potato and onion.
Oh, wonderful. Yeah. There's something about those ingredients that really mellow out that rotted fish flavor to the point where it's acceptably edible. I still think everybody should try it straight out of the can.
Theodoros Kalapilios is the owner, bartender, and chef here at Varvari. When not wielding a knife or spatula, he's smoking a cigarette or knocking back an ouzo in water. But this guy can cook.
Look at that, one burner and about 1 square foot of coals.
And they turn out humble little street dishes that are really popular with all the fishermen.
Very, very good. It's what I said in the beginning.
You know, this place is off the grid. They keep homemade ouzo in old scotch bottles, and no one worries about the cigarette burn marks around the ashtrays. They serve whatever's cheapest and freshest. Today, Theodoros has a batch of fresh octopus ink sacs. In the wild, an octopus uses its ink to dull the sense of smell of predators and to cloud the water while making its escape. But there's no escape today.
He's going to poach the sacks of the octopus ink so that they get a little bit firm on the outside. That way they're easier to fry.
Each sack takes less than a minute to poach.
And the octopus ink sacks were a favored dish of the sponge divers. You had to have a strong stomach for it.
And you also had to utilize every single part of anything that came into the boat for food because you were away at sea for months at a time, sponge diving. Historically and culturally, this is a very important dish. But even here on Kalymnos, cooking the ink sacs like this is a dying art and a messy one.
It's still a really gentle, gentle operation because right now what you have is basically an extremely soft boiled egg, and he's trying very hard during this process of dusting with flour and frying not to break them. It's a messy job.
Here, excuse me. Yeah. Because I know your hands are. Yeah. Just helping out. First time I've tried this dish. I've had the head, the legs, and I've eaten the ink when it's been mixed into other dishes as a seasoning or as a coloring agent, but never the entire ink sac fried whole. Wow. It's got the consistency of oatmeal, the flavor of chopped chicken livers. I think this would fool most food experts in a blind taste test. Well, no one's gonna guess that it's octopus ink sacs. Come on.